as I mentioned in my last video, that we will be creating the visio diagram using the predefined templates. So continuing from there, this is the second video in this series, and now we will be creating a wireframe visio diagram for a mobile app using the predefined template of wireframe mobile app. So here I click the create button. So here you can see that all the required elements are there. On the left hand side you can see more shapes. So if you want to pull in some other shapes, icons, diagrams, so you can pull it up. Otherwise, the required key elements for creating the mobile app wireframe, all of those things are there. For example, if we go here, you will see all these common icons required for creating the wireframe diagram. Quick shapes are there, wildcards and containers are there. So if we start with this, you can see very easily this diagram can be created here. We can increase and decrease the size. We can pull in other items here. If we don't like it, we can simply go and delete it. It's as simple as that. And these grid lines help you to actually do the alignment properly. So like this, you can easily create your wireframe diagram. Right now we are creating a login screen for a basic app. We want to put in the mobile controls, we can put it here. We want to put the search bar on the top. So you see that it's basically the app requirement. Once you have freeze the app requirements, you can put it in the action here for everybody in your team to look at it, understand it, whether it solves the problem or not. But it's meaningful only after you have decided that what you want to achieve from this app. It basically helps you speeding up the work. And here you can see, while I am trying to put in the signal strength, it is showing me the capacity for that. If I change it, and you can see the on the top bar, all those things have changed. So here I did not add these elements in any order, but I can rearrange them easily to have the order that I like. So as we want the status bar on the top, so we are rearranging it. So here we have got our status bar, then we have got our search bar, and here is the logo. So very quickly we could do that, and that's not where it ends. You have got this ribbon commands, and using which you can actually make a lot more changes in terms of the font and everything. So if it is here, we can simply go and change the font the way we expect or we want to see. So for example, if I change it to Rockwell, this is how it would look. If I am making a very funky application and I would want to have a very funky font here, I can just put it like that. So it gives me a look and feel for the application in a very effective manner. When I am creating more than one page, after this I want to have a look at the screen, that what would be the screen looking like. I'll go back to mobile cards and containers. I'll click on the same frame so that the entire application is actually in sync with what we are showing. Because the screen size or device size is not going to change from one screen to another. We are developing the screen navigation here. So that is why I simply copied this status bar and trying to actually ensure that the screen size is same across both the diagrams. So here I have copied that screen, the status bar. And here is my list item. And you can see that I am trying to create a very funky sort of app here. So when we are in the era that we are living, there is a lot more which is going on, and we all are trying to grab the attention of the end user, the limited attention that we have got, and we are trying to have it with through our apps and other work. So we would possibly want to have the application in such a way which is different in look and feel, but at the same time easier for the consumer to understand. So we all end up doing some experiments. So this wireframe technique helps you to actually do that experimentation without investing much of the time and other resources in actually firstly creating the POCs and then figuring out that okay, this worked with the end user or not. So basically your A/B testing you can do of a certain level before actually launching the actual app. So here you can see that we have created a very complicated screen with some things in place and certain items with some videos, some images, some profile or something. So we can, whatever the idea that we have got, we can simply go and test it with the end user, that this would be the first screen that they would see after logging into the app. And we can ask from them whether they like this app or not. So you can see that Visio, by using this predefined template of Visio, you can very easily create such basic wireframes for the mobile app, which is a great tool for the developers, UI UX designers, marketing department. If you are trying to get into a new product space and want to outreach to more and more potential customers, so you can, like, depending on your problem statement, your requirement, you can use this tool to create these kind of wireframes for the mobile app, your websites, any kind of basic brochure that you are creating with the possible app that you are planning to launch. So all these things can be done using Visio. So this is where I feel that you have got some really brilliant users, use cases with Visio here. And here I am just showing you how you can simply change the font and grab the attention with all these different fonts which are there. So we have got our basic wireframe of the app in place. I hope you like this video. Share your comments. If you've got any suggestion, you can share it as well. If you like this video, then give us the thumbs up. If you would like to follow the further videos or would like to get the updates about our upcoming videos in your inbox, then press the bell icon. We look forward to interact with you. Thank you for watching this video.